very warm welcome to this time travel adventure with Eventyr ASMR. Tonight you'll be guided through a relaxing and comforting journey in time. You will be visiting different periods in history, and at every destination, a warm-hearted and gentle friend will take care of you in a moment of need. You'll find yourself in all kind of troublesome situations, a prisoner, deserter, or just wounded, hungover, or maybe even cursed by an ancient spell. First, you arrive to the prison cell in the dungeons of a castle in the late Middle Ages. You seem to be some kind of a rebel, and at first, the Scullery Maid is obviously afraid of you. But deep down she knows that your quest for justice and equality is right, and when she sees how you've been hurt, she does her best to take care of you. Be quiet. Please be quiet. It's me. The men who saw it, and the rest of us who heard it. I came to soothe your wounds. It looks terrible. Your ear, your eye, and your hand. My mother, she knows of physics, medicine. She learned from her mother. She used to work in a convent. She wasn't a nun, obviously. She was a scullery maid, like me. But she had wit. I made this ointment from her recipe. Some of the herbs she smuggled from the medicine garden in the convent and planted in her own garden. And my mother, she kept them in a secret place in the garden, hidden amongst the gerfel and parsley. So it all blessed and sacred, no witchcraft. It is made from the root of tamarind and horseradish, which will burn the ailment away and stop the swelling. Cinnamon will warm up the blood, and honey will sweeten the good fluids. Chamomile will cool down the fluids again. The gentle, blessed scent of our good lady, and thus prevent wound fever. And the melted fat of a blessed animal will seal the skin and protect the wounds of impure thoughts and evil wishes. Before I came here, I rubbed my hand with ashes and vinegar and then cleansed them with boiled cloth. It makes for healing hands, according to my mother. Now come here, very carefully. I know it must hurt terribly when you move. Come a bit closer and I can reach your face between the bars. This will hurt, but you must trust me and you must keep completely silent. I need both my hands to wash you and apply the ointment. But you can squeeze my arm if the pain is too strong. All right, I will start with your eye and your ear. I will wash them with boiled water. I couldn't fare to get my hands on wine. It's well guarded nowadays because of the mercenaries lodging. My mother said that wine or spirit is the best, but water that has been cleansed with fire can work too. The water is like the human soul. You can't see the wickedness, but the fires of the purgatory will clean the soul, just like the water when it's boiled. Did well. I got the blood and the pus of your eye and your ear. Your ear needs sewing with catgut, but that's an impossible task down here. So you must just pray it heals over. Now we'll apply the ointment. Have a strong grip. No, it's okay. I'm fine. Now I just need to look at your hand, all right? Let me first wash it. Yes, you can take it a little closer. Can the chain reach? Used to pain, but everyone got their breaking points, right? I just hope this isn't yours. Shh. It's over now. You'll soon feel better.
Now, after a very short journey in time, you arrive a few days later in the prison cell again. This time the scullery maid has prepared for your escape, but firstly she needs to check on your wounds and especially the damage to your eye.
Good night. It is me. You look better. Let me see your wounds. No poison of the blood, as I can see. Does it hurt? Well, all right. No, don't worry. A little tenderness, it's
nothing. I will wash it with extra chamomile and cinnamon. Cold and heat to balance the fluids. It's all right. It will hurt a bit, but you tried worse. Hey, girl. Okay. Good. Now let me see your eye. How's your sight? Well, I brought you light so you can practice. Look at my finger, okay? Keep your head still and move your eyes. Down. Okay. Yes. The moment is fine. Okay. Now I'll hold my hand in front of your eyes and then look. Yes, in the center of your eyes. When I move my hand and reveal the candlelight. Okay? Well, of course it hurts. Then don't blink. I'm sorry. Of course, I know it hurts. I'll try another way, okay? You keep looking at me, and I'll just move the candle into your vision and see how your eye reacts, okay? Okay, yes. Don't look directly into the light. Try not to blink. Just the exterior, the wounds. So it's good. I'll wash it and your ear with the extract, okay? Yes, you can close your eye now. Your ear will never again be that of a prize-winning hiver. But then, I guess it wasn't to begin with. Well, quarrelsome dogs get dirty coats. I've done what I can for you now. Fortune and prayers will decide.
Now we'll leave the Dark Ages and continue our travel to the beginning of the 18th century, around year 1710. Now the tables have turned, and you'll find yourself on the very top of society, but not so much on top of your game. You're a baron who awakens after a duel, and although you might not be deadly wounded, you could surely use the tender care of a chambermaid. Please enjoy the comfort of the 18th century bedside manners and just a little bit of light sarcasm.
No, don't move. You just hurt yourself. Well, I warned you, didn't I? Now, let me help you with the arm. Now, that's better. Yes, you were wounded in the shoulder. Well, not so much a deadly wound, more like a superficial scratch. Now, let me just gently remove your shirt in order to clean the wound. Yes, sir, I'm afraid it is necessary. You don't want to catch a wound fever now, do you? Yes, I'll be careful. Just lie still. Now, that's good. Now I need to clean the wound. Now, here we go. Yes. Yes, you need to lie still. Yes. My lord. Of course I did not press too hard on purpose. But you can never be too careful with these superficial wounds. They can be ever so insidious. Yes, I need to bite your tongue. No, it's not bleeding anymore. Yes, we still need to be careful. Yes, no, no, no. Yes, I know it stings a bit. But you're going to be just fine. Very good. Dress the wound, yes, with this dry, clean cloth. Yes, it need to be rather tight. Yes. Here we go. Just sit still. Yes. Just like this. Very good. Very good. Now, I brought some medicine from Farmer Tuckett. He assured me it will do wonders for your arm. Oh no, I'm sure it will be nothing like the last time with that unfortunate leech incident. But I'm afraid it will probably not be very favorable to the taste. Here you go, my lord. Yes, maybe it's rather awful. Well, you're truly audacious.
For the next destination, we'll only travel a couple of weeks. The setting is the same, but this time the trouble is not a noble duel, but a night out, which left you with a terrible hangover.
Oh no, even last night it was feeling under the weather. Now of course I didn't do it on purpose. How would I know? Well, oh my dear, you really look most awful. No, no, don't worry. I'm sure his lordship will survive. It's just a hangover. And certainly not the first or the last. Well, yes, my lord, without a doubt, the most excruciating hangover ever known to mankind. But, let me take a look at you. You're bruised and battered. Did you fall? Oh, you were in a fight. Now, let me take a proper look at you. Can you try to sit up? Well, carefully. No unnecessary movement of the hat. No. Let me help you. Yes. Yes. Can't just support you? Very good. Okay. Yes. Your nose. It's all swollen. But I don't think it's broken. Eyes, black and blue. Now, first of all, I need to wash all the dried blood off of your face. Yes. Let me just, ever so gently, clean your face with warm water and a soft, soft cloth. Now sit still, or the water will drip on you. Yes. Yes, it hurts, but the water doesn't sting. No, no, no. It's just the bruises and the cuts. Now you need to sit still. Yes, very good. Okay, just need to clean the blood off your ear. Yes. Yes, you're very courageous indeed. Now your face is clean. Now let me have a look at you. Yes, I'll just gently touch and dab. Your forehead, a little bump. Yes, that's all. Cheekbones. Bruised. Yeah. Your jawline. Chin. Okay. Good. Yes. And the nose, of course.
Inez is bruised, but not broken. Your lips is a little swollen, yes, but no damage to the teeth. I'm a little more concerned about your eye. Can you open it a little more? Yes. Yes, I know it hurts. Now I need to check if there's any damage to the eyeball. I'm just going to shine a bright light into your eye, just to see if the pupil dilates. Okay? Yes. Now I'm just going to move the candle slowly from one side to another. And you need to follow the flame with your eyes. No, not with your head. Just with your eyes, okay? Yes. It is sore when you move your eye from side to side. Very good, my lordship. I don't think there's any damage to the eyeball. It's just the exterior. Well, yes, my lord. That is, of course, bad enough. I recommend a poultice with soothing herbs added. Yes. I'll ask the kitchen to prepare it and bring it. Now you also have a nasty scratch by the ear. Yes, I have a cloth soaked in chamomile water. I'll just gently place it on the scratch. Yes, that is to prevent any redness and swelling. Lie still, my lordship. Yes, it probably will hurt a little bit. Very good. Very good. Yes. Okay, just sit still. Yes, and I'll dress it with a dry, clean cloth to keep it in place. I do need to make it rather firm. Yes, to keep it in place. I'm sorry, your lordship. Yes, it must hurt. Yes, you're very audacious.
Let's continue our travel through history. And we'll reach our next destination in Denmark around the year 1864. You're a soldier from the Second Schleswig War, but you deserted and you now seek refuge in the house of a friendly neighbor. Will your friend offer to help you, although she puts herself in danger? You arrive at a small cottage, children working outside. You approach the window and look into the humble kitchen. Then, with your heart in your throat, you decide to risk it all and open the door.
I'm sure it's not as bad as you think. Are you hurt?
deserted. Well, I guess that is bad. Okay, let's not panic. We will think of something. After a good cup of coffee, I'm sure we will find a solution. But firstly, let me wash your face. You've been on the road for many days, and it's hot and dirty. And, well, you look like a grey ghost. Let me get you cleaned up. Wash your forehead. All that dust is clinging to you. Yeah. Spit it right. Cooling of the water brings you calm. That is good. Clears your face, but it also clears your thought. Yeah, close your eyes. Just wash your eyelids. Let me wash the lamps. So dry. It's much better. Now wash your cheeks. I'll just wash your ears, okay? And we're done. Yes. Much better. Much better. That was an improvement. Now you look like a pale ghost. Well, I'm sure a good, strong cup of coffee will bring some colour into your cheeks.
Journey continues for another 50 years or so. At this destination, we will visit yet another troublesome period in time, namely World War I. You are a British soldier at a Danish hospital for prisoners of war. You crashed in your airplane, and apart from a wounded shoulder, you also suffer from shell shock. Luckily, a warm-hearted nurse is here to comfort and encourage you.
morning. How are you doing? The other patient needs rest. Are you cold? I can understand that. It's very difficult to keep a barrack heated. I brought you. And first, I need to take care of your wounds. First of all, I'm going to remove your binding. Don't worry, I'm just gonna cut the binding, okay? Just like that. Really carefully. Yeah. I know it hurts. It's okay. You don't need to put up a brave face for me. I know, pain. I've seen it all. I know what it does to you. Remove it. Okay, yes. Very gently. Like this. Yeah. Okay. Just like this. Yeah, it's okay. It's gone now. It looks very good. Yes. Very fine. Okay. I'm just gonna wash it. Very careful, okay? Just like that. Yes. Yes, I know. It's okay, I know. I know. Yes. Very good. Very good. Okay. Yes. I'm gonna use this. Yes. To disinfect the wall. Use this little piece of cotton. Yes. This will feel cold and sting a bit, but it's soon over. I know. I know. But it will clean it very well. Yes. Very good. That's good. Yes, just a little bit more. Yeah, I'm soon done. Yes. That's it. Yes. The rest is easy. Here it is. This one would be on the wound. Then I'll put some band-aid on. And then the binding. Yes. And then you'll get a clasp to hold your arm. Yes. When you sit upright. Of course you will. You'll be fine. Very soon. The wound looks good. Much better than last night. The doctor did well, and the stitches are nice and small. It will be a very presentable scar. Okay, I'll put this on. Just like that. Yes. Yeah. Can you hold it with your good arm? Very good. Yes, that's good. Now I'll just take the bandage. Yeah. Very good. Okay, yes, just like that. And I'll put the bandage around. Okay, you can move your hand now. Very good. Yes. Yes, it's... Yeah. It sticks in the good skin. Very nicely. Super. That was that. Now with this one. Yeah. Yes. Will hold and support your arm so you can sit upright, walk around. Yes, shaped as a triangle, and I'll bind it over your shoulder like this. Yes, now it's nice and soft. Yes, there you see. Yes. It's quite big, but you have to, you know, fold it into a triangle. Yes. Like this. Yes. I just have to move your arm a little bit in the right position. It's okay. Yes. It's okay. Good. Here we go. Yes. Yes, it's right. And just tie a knot up here on your shoulder. Yeah. We'll adjust it when you sit upright so it'll have the right length. So it'll keep your arm. Just like that. If you ever had a broken collarbone, you know exactly what this is. Yes. Yeah. That was good. Super. Yes, it's perfect. Your arm will be perfectly fine. And when all this is over, you'll be able to go back to your family. Very good. Now I have some medicine for you. Yes. Yes, it will. It will take care of the pain. Yes, and hopefully to drink it. There you go. That's fine, yeah. Yeah. Yes, you know, just one of these pills. No, it's not too big. Yeah, just take it. Yes, put a little bit of water. There's a glass next to you. Although you give. As I said, you'll soon be fine.
You have now reached the final destination for this time travel experience. A small private library in the 1920s. You've consulted an old rival out of pure desperation. You might have cheated her out of a treasure, the Holy Grail, but now you're afraid that you have been deadly cursed by the protectors of the Grail. A nasty wound had appeared on your shoulder, and you need her help to care for both the wound and the curse.
Well, hello. Look what the cat brought in. You're not superstitious. And well, frankly, too greedy, cocksure and stupid to scare easily. But now, you're definitely scared. Out of your wits. Now, let me clean the wound. Bind it, and after that, we'll take a rational look on this midwife's tale of a curse. Okay? Okay. Let's have a look. Now I'm just going to remove your shirt ever so carefully, okay? Such a baby, okay? Yeah. It's okay. I'm gonna do it now. Okay. Again. No. I'm not worried. It's just... It's gonna be fine. Don't worry. Okay. Let's see what we got. I'm gonna claim it, okay? Just gonna find something. I think we need a rather strong disinfection. What about this one? Might do the trick. I'm just going to put a little of this on. Now, this will sting a little. A lot. Don't worry. Yes. Okay. Here we go. Don't worry, it's not as bad as the first one. It will feel cold, but it will only sting a tiny bit, okay? Now where's the other? Here's the other piece of cotton. This is good stuff. Okay. Here we go. Yeah, it smells strong. That'll do you good. Got a little bit of cocaine in it. That will be perfect, okay? Yes. Yeah. You take this home with you, okay? It will be good for the pain. Yeah. Let's see what else have we got. A little thick. Okay. Here we go. Absorbent cotton. And of course, Band-Aid. never died. Like this. Yes. Does it hurt? Well, it will hurt a little, okay? But it shouldn't stop the blood flow, okay? Just need to keep this in its place. You need to keep an eye on it because, well, as I said, I'm sure it's completely natural, but it does look a little peculiar.
Now, my dear traveller, the journey has ended. It has been a pleasure to accompany you through nearly 500 years of comfort and care, and a little bit of sarcasm and sassiness. Thank you for traveling with Eventyr ASMR. We truly hope it has been a pleasant and relaxing time traveling venture, and we hope to see you back very soon.